so many people. So many people, man. I say, you know, like, God will give people messages. He'll tell us chosen and stuff. And to so many people out here, they will seem like crazy people. And I've said this before, but they will. People would literally think that they are loony. Like, they are crazy, you know? And then when you go back, like I said, into time, you know, into the old times, the old days. I mean, a lot of the people that God chose, His chosen ones, He told them things that were impossible to man, but that was possible to Him. And the moment that people literally started, you know, going around, hearing about it, they was thinking that the person was crazy, you know. They thought, listen, when God promised, and see, that's the most funniest yet beautiful thing about God. He'll promise you the impossible just so that you can know that whatever it is that He done promised you, it was all Him and nobody else could get the credit and the glory for it. You know what I'm saying? So, mind you, that at the end of the day, mind you that when He spoke to Abraham, when He spoke to, you know, Sarah, He promised them a promised child at a very old age. And even Sarah herself laughed. And God was making a promise, you know, to her as well. Then you have, like I said, people like Joseph. You know, the same thing. You know, Joseph was like, listen, I dreamed, you know, these dreams. And, you know, people, I mean, they criticized him. Even people that loved him so much, such as his father, you know, or whatever, literally was like, I love you, son, but you're going to be much talking about me and your mom and your sis, you know, your brothers or whatever. They're going to literally, we're going to be servant to you, or we're gonna bow down to you, or we're gonna, you know, you're gonna be this great person. Like, I mean, come on now, you're going too far with it as my favorite child, you know, or whatever. And then, you know, you go on to, you know, dealing with the whole Job situation with him having lost everything and, you know, or whatever, and still keeping his faith regardless of such, you know, or whatever. And then, not to mention even with Noah, you know, and I love that because, you know, I can only imagine, like, with Joseph, it was his family. And, you know, we as people, we got a lot of things, you know, going on, even stuff, you know, that's minor that, you know, we say we're gonna do or it's gonna happen to us. And, you know, your own people sometimes be looking at you sideways. But to deal with the fact of having Noah be out here building something for something that had never, ever, ever even taken place was on a whole different caliber. Do you know how mighty your faith has to be? Do you know how strong your faith has to literally be to get out here in the open amongst people you know and people you don't, and to take on a task of building something, you know, and people are literally talking about you like they think you a madman? I mean, I'm sure if they had mental institutes back then or whatever the case may be, they probably would have threw Noah all the way up in there because he was literally doing something and it made no sense. It made no sense, you know, to nobody or whatever. But, you know, that's the beauty of God's grace and mercy. That is the beauty of God saying that He's gonna come in and do extraordinary things for you in your life, you know. And it's crazy because, you know, like I said, you will have so many people out here, even Christian people, Don't get me wrong. You will have so many people out here that will say so much how much they love God, how much God means to them, you know, et cetera, et cetera. And then when it comes down to having the type of faith in God and the things in which God said he would do, period, no matter whose life it is, you know, they won't believe in it as much as they would believe in other things that they have no business believing in. They won't believe in it or trust in it or have as much faith in it as much as they do when it comes down to them having faith in stuff they don't got no business having faith in. And it's crazy because that is the world that we're living in right now. It's a lot of things, you know, that a lot of people, a lot of chosen ones, they don't, you know, bother to share because, you know, they feel like, I ain't even, you know, it was, I tell you what, when it happened, I'll just be able to give it to you then, because y'all just, I'm tired of you looking at me sideways, and I want to encourage people, I want to encourage a lot of people right now to not be discouraged about the naysayers. Do not be discouraged. If God says open your mouth, open your mouth. If God said, and it don't matter who believe in you, whether they believe in what you're saying or not, it's not going to stop the glory that he is planning on doing for you in your life. Or it don't matter if you may seem like a crazy person, because again, if God has promised you that he's going to do some mighty things for you in your life or whatever, that he's going to use you as an example to be able to represent him in a way in which he needs you to represent him now more than ever because of all that is transpiring and that is going on out here in this world today, then you do what it is that God told you to do. You be what it is that God told you to be or that God has called you to be or whatever, because at the end of the day, it's just like this. Whether people want to believe in the words of God, whether people read their Bible every day, whether people, you know, read their Bible on a weekly basis or whatever the case may be, or they don't, it's not going to stop whatever God said was going to happen from happening. It's not going to change the fact that God is who he said he is and that he can do all of what he said that he can do. It's not going to stop that. It's not going to stop that at all, you know, or whatever. So, as always, you know, I'm just saying, you know, I have to speak on it because so many times people don't. And I know what it may feel like, you know, to have to hide or to not want to say certain things or not want to say anything at all because of how you may feel like other people may look at you or may view you based off of what God has told you. No, so, yeah, because, man, I constantly, you know, share my experiences that I've had with God, and I'm grateful, I'm thankful to have been able to have the connection and the relationship that I have, you know, with him. And part of me being a vessel means sharing things, whether it makes me look a certain type of way to a certain type of people or not, you know, I do it. Take me to the car. I don't have much to bring. Truth is, I'm tired. I am through. I'm all burned out. If you was here, you would be too. Take me to the car. To be asked what I think about a person who's head of the county that my family and I have been going through a lot of trials and tests from being in the same seat that
my family and I have been in for the last almost 3 years. To be asked how I feel about that, well, just to know that two of the corrupt judges, two of them already are no longer in office no more, and then to see this go on and all of these things had nothing to do with me physically. I pray that God have had mercy on these individuals, period. That has always been my earnest prayer. But I can't but help but think that when you go back to God's word and you talk about the whole, when my enemies and my foes came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumble and fail. It reminds you of that, to see what that sheriff is going through right now, which hasn't even been a whole 12 months, and you're talking about 30 plus in my family and our situation. That's what comes into my mind. Or though an army should encamp against me, and I mean, I don't like to see nobody in this situation. Nobody innocent anyway. And to have the legal defense attorney argue about, you know, this person's innocence and this person's innocence, meaning that, you know, the people that work alongside them's innocence, you know, and to know that I'm a victim of violations of civil rights, maybe not that particular civil rights, or maybe not that particular, you know, situation, but just to know that I'm a family of six, and all of us were victims to our civil rights violations from this same particular county. All of the judicial systems, the officer badges, you name it, the jail. It feels surreal. It feels like, I don't know, it's like bittersweet, because on a contrary, you know, like I said, currently, still dealing with my situation, still dealing with damages, still dealing with losses, still dealing with everything, and then you got, okay, even with me not playing a part in the situation at hand, you know, people are literally, God is literally handling these individuals, you know, one by one, and I don't know, like, I'm like, okay, God, I'm just here to see what you gonna do next when it comes down to that situation, when it comes down to mine. I know what you told me about me, you know, so I don't know, I'm just, y'all, I got a bittersweet emotion, that's all, you know, so, yeah. That's my feeling. That's my input on the situation or whatever. So, yeah.